Hello, I'm Minister Raheem Kassed Otten, Chairman of the Board of Directors of the United American Progress Association, and we're here today to speak to you about buying black. Our host of this show is Ernestine Stansberry of the International Pro-Life Federation, and we're going to be talking today to Dr. Webb Evans, the founder and president of the United American Progress Association, which I am proud to be a member of and to be the chairman of the board of directors. Welcome to the show, Dr. Evans.
Thanks a lot. I'm glad to be here. I'm always glad to have an opportunity to tell my people how we can help ourselves. For too long, black people have depended on other people to take care of our needs. Anytime you're depending on somebody else to take care of your need, you're going to always be in need. And that's where black people are today. Coming out of slavery, and Abraham Lincoln signed the Emancipation Proclamation, and everybody said he freed us, but he didn't.
That's right.
He stopped others from owning us. We didn't have any money. We didn't have any job. We didn't have any land. We didn't have a mule. We had to depend on them. And when you're depending on somebody else for everything, you're still the slave of those people you depend on.
You're right. Well, let me ask you a question, because we only have a few minutes.
Yeah.
Now, we know that you've been promoting buying black for at least 50 years under the United American Progress Association. And you've seen a lot in your time, getting ready to celebrate your 98th birthday coming up.
That's right.
And over those years, working with Martin Luther King and others, you've seen, like you've told me, history repeating itself. Can you expound on what you meant by that? You lived long enough to see history repeat itself.
Yeah, well, I said it was, I've seen history repeating itself. I marched with Dr. King. I marched with Lou Palmer. I marched with Reverend Jesse Jackson. But the biggest mistake that black people have made, we haven't learned to march to each other with our dollars. Mm-hmm. Now, when I say I've lived to see history repeating itself, I started in the movement under A. Philip Randolph. Okay. And under Philip Randolph, and when I started, he was talking about a march on Washington for Washington to give us some jobs. And he never stated about marching to your people with your dollars and create some job. Now we have Al Sharpton is on WN all the time and, up until the 16th talking about marching on Washington. The mm-hmm. same thing that we started with. And I never hear him say what would happen if black people ever started marching to one another with that dollar. We could create those jobs we're trying to get others to give us.
That's right.
We don't seem to realize that black people, the money that we spend, if we were spending with each other, we could create the job. We've reached the top in just about, well, in everything. Now mm-hmm. we're signing this president. With Jesse Owens, we beat anybody running. With Joe Louis and Muhammad Ali, we beat anybody fighting. With Althea Gibson and the Williams sisters, we beat anybody playing tennis. With Larry Roberts and Larry Doby, we beat anybody playing baseball. And now we got president, one of the best presidents in the world. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to money, that's why we're acting up. I used to say that God will do for us what he's done for anybody. He's done for us what he's done for everybody else. And a lot of people criticize Bill Cosby when he said that not all our problems caused by others keeping us down. A lot of our problems caused by what we're not doing to get up.
Get up. I agree with you.
Yeah.
And now you mentioned the president. And we know that recently America went and helped in bringing Muammar Gaddafi down. They also went and I believe they brought Osama bin Laden down. Now, today, looking forward into the future, based on the condition of black people and white people, middle class and all, occupying Wall Street, occupying LaSalle Street here in Chicago, occupying Oakland, California, and throughout the entire United States, there's a protest, a semi-revolution. So moving into 2012, Dr. Evans, what do you see dealing with the condition of our people? Do you see it getting better? Do you see it getting worse? What about the world conditions? Give us your insight,
well,
your wisdom.
Number one, let's start with us. I think we need to do some occupying. Occupy the black community.
Amen.
Yeah.
Occupy our streets.
Marcus Garvey, see, I'm a firm believer in Marcus Garvey. He's an any people. I don't care who they are. If you're the majority in an area, you should control that area. Everybody's doing it but us. Chinamen control Chinatown. Greek control Greek town. And we just live in the black community. As nobody but us live in one neighborhood and outside of it own more in it than the people who live in it. Mm-hmm. And far as the world is concerned, it's hard to tell how things will go because they stayed with certain types of war material in Iraq they had and found out that it wasn't there. Mm-hmm. All those men lost their lives for nothing. And then, like I said, they've killed Gaddafi. Mm-hmm. And yet, most of us don't know just what the whole story in
that's
that
right,
and
right.
how it's going to affect the world setup because you see, he at one time was trying to get black people the world together.
That's right.
And there are certain forces in the world don't want to see us
that's
to come
right,
together.
That's right.
And that's why I say the first thing that black people need to start controlling where they live and own the business. Now, I have a book called How to Get Off the Economic Bottom. Mm-hmm. Sorry I didn't bring one with me, but you can get it at 450 East 7th and 9th Street, How Black Can Get Off the Economic Bottom. It tells in that what Marcus Garvey had to say. It tells what Honorable Elijah Muhammad had to say, help sell. It tells what W. Du Bois said, we got to start teaching them economics in our churches. Mm-hmm. We got all kinds of clubs in our church, Mama Club, Papa Club, Mary Club, Susie Club, but we don't have an economic club. We don't have an investment club. We don't have anything dealing with controlling our dollars.
And why don't we?
Well, it's because there's nothing any worse than the after effects of slavery other than slavery itself. And black people still suffer from the after effects of slavery. We were told coming out of slavery that white people were supposed to own the business. We're supposed to be their servants.
Okay.
Now, that was back there years ago. And up until the day 2011, black people still looking for white people to give us a job. And the people who create jobs will always be working more than those who just look for a job. And all of my life, and I'm quite sure all of yours, because I'm a lot older than you, black people have been looking for white people to give us a job. And when if we would put our dollars together, we can create those jobs. Now, we're creating thousands of jobs, but there's millions of jobs for other people, because we're spending all our money mostly with other people. And
well, how much time do we have as a people to do that, Dr. Evans?
Oh, very little. Very little, very little. I don't know our coming generation going to have it worse than we have it unless we come together and start putting our dollar where it's going to help build a better future for little black boys and girls. As it is now, our dollars are helping others. Like everybody seems to be so happy about all these business coming in our neighborhood. We should be opening up some business. We should be opening up some department store. We should be opening up some hardware store. We should be opening up some more hotel. And we have enough churches, but see, that's why I said we are still suffering for the after effects of slavery because they stole us to stay away from that. And they didn't care whether we went to heaven or hell. They didn't want us competing with what they had here on earth. And before we go anywhere, I believe God wants us to take care of what's here on earth.
And I agree. You see, we're talking to a living legend who's experienced a lot of things in his 98 years, and the Creator allowed him to stay here and be in his right mind to share this information with us. You heard it here first about how we're going to be able to try our best to survive in 2012. We got to do for self. We got to create our own jobs. We can't look for the people that put us in the condition to get us out of the condition.
Amen.
We must come together.
Let me
see. Other organizations, we have to work together, not separately. The Nation of Islam, the New Black Panther Party, the United American Progress Association, the Moore Science Temple of America, the Temple of Mercy Association. We got to come together. We got to do this ourselves. Dr. Evans, give us some last words before we close this session out.
Yeah, let me say this about Dr. King. It was never Dr. King's intention to march all of his life. Mm-hmm. He stated it. I worked with Dr. King. Dr. King, and before he passed, he said he was changed the struggle for civil rights to a struggle for economic and political empowerment. And once he made that statement, they killed him.
That's right.
So it was never his intention to march. Because when I talked with him, I said, really strange. I said, the same people who causing us to march, I said, is one we're spending all our money with. Look like we'd be funding with each other. And what I'm saying to all those who are listening, if we live together, we go to church together, we sing together, we pray and shout together, doesn't it seem like we should put some dollars together?
That's right.
And create some job for the future little black boys and girls instead of looking for somebody to give us a job.
And that's the solution. Homelessness, unemployment at an all-time high.
We suffer from everything negative. With all the churches we have, yet we still don't have more love than other people. You know what I mean? 10 blacks are being killed to every one white. And well, we done the killing.
We got to end this session now. And it was great again being able to sit here and talk with you. And I know I'm working with you, and I've been working with you for a little while.
Let me ask the people out there, listen, one thing.
Mm-hmm.
I want everybody out there to ask your pastor, why is it that we have more churches than all the rest of the regions put together? And I'd like for them to report at our next meeting at 1716 West on 79th Street on the fourth Monday in next month. I'd like for y'all to report to us. Ask your pastor, let's see what he said. And come to find the average pastor don't know himself why we got more churches than anybody else, but we don't have more love, we don't have more compassion, and then I have the answer in my book.
That's right.
How black can get off the economic bottom and tell you why we got more churches than anybody else, but the average pastor doesn't know.
Well, that's every fourth Monday, 1716 West on 79th Street, United American Progress Association, 7 p.m. Come on out. That's our UAPA Black Business Network. A pleasure again.
The pleasure is mine.
On this
stage. The pleasure is mine. Yes, thank you.
All right. Heard it here first. Take care.
That's
peace.
It. Nah. That's all.
So many times we walk through life never caring about the other guy. Still we hope things will change. Inside their eyes, you'll find the kids have grown as cold as ice. Now we must make a change. Oh.